Hey, so today I'm making a video which is gonna be 5 favorite songs from the 80s part 2, which I was gonna make like 4 years ago, but I never got around to it. And now it has been more than a year since I made my first one. So this is gonna be the best songs from the 80s part 2. Number 11 is Wham with the Wham rap called Do You Enjoy What You Do. Like, this is just a good song for like so many reasons, but it's because it's such an energetic hip happy song, and plus it's just a really cute video that goes with the song, and I always like get up and dance type of songs, so that's why I like this song and that's why it's number 11. Number 10 is Hole in My Heart by Cyndi Lauper, because this is a really good song, and I always used to listen to Cyndi Lauper when I was a little kid, and her songs have just always been in everything, and a lot of stuff that I watch and listen to, whatever, whatever. Of course, this song comes from the movie Vibes with Jeff Goldblum, which I did watch. I mean, it could have been better, but couldn't all of Jeff Goldblum's movies have been better? So anyways, that's why, what's it called? Hole in My Heart is number 10. The sea of trouble, the land of pain. You're sending me where it always rains. Oh, reconsider, I'm begging you some hesitation. Number 9 is Mr. Brownstone by Guns N' Roses, because in my opinion, this is the best, if not one of the best, Guns N' Roses songs. And I just love the whole beat and everything to it. And it's just a really, really good song for so many reasons. Like, the style of the song, the way it's done, the way the words are delivered is just such a good song. And that's why it's number 9, because it's just really good. Number 8 is Everybody Wants to Rule the World. And this is really the song that started my, I guess you could say, obsession with the 80s way a long time ago. When I first heard this song, I was like 9 years old. And I just was like, I love this song so much. And that's why Everybody Wants to Rule the World by Tears for Fears is number 8. So glad we've almost made it. So sad they had to fade it. Everybody wants to move. Number 7 is Girls Just Wanna Have Fun from Cyndi Lauper, because, again, song I always listened to as a little kid, and I always remember listening to the song on my first day of school back in like 2005. And I was like 4 years old. Well, it had to be 2006 then. It had to be 2006 if I was old enough to go to real school for the first time. But I'm pretty sure it was 2005. I don't know though, because I wouldn't have been 5 until... But anyways, either 2005 or 2006 is when I first was listening to Girls Just Wanna Have Fun by Cyndi Lauper, and that song has just stuck with me through all the years, and I used to like that song as a little kid, so that's why it is number 7. Some boys take a beautiful girl and hide her away from the rest of the world. I wanna be the one to walk in the sun. Oh, girls, they wanna have fun. Oh, girls, they wanna have... Number 6 is Forget Me Nots from Patrice Rushen. And this song, for the saxophone alone, like, oh my gosh, that alone makes it a 10 out of 10 quality song. Number five is Time After Time by Cyndi Lauper. Because, see, the thing is, my mom used to sing this song when I was a little kid, whether she remembers or not, but she used to be singing this song all the time. And so I never knew it was like kind of a duet in a way. I never knew there was two people singing it. So when I first heard this song properly for the first time, I thought it was a remix because I didn't know there was like a man singing in the background. And obviously our mom is one person. She can't do both voices, but I was always like confused. But when I first heard the real song, but I really like it. And I liked the beginning of the song because it's just such a nice song. Like the pace and everything is just so nice and just wonderful, 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 which is why it is number five. Confusion is nothing new. Flashback, warm nights, almost left behind. Suitcase of memories, time after some time. Number four is the song Monkey by George Michael. And the thing is, okay, so our mom always used to like George Michael, Wham, all that, whatever, whatever. And I knew I liked George Michael. I liked some of their songs, whatever, whatever. I liked some of Wham's songs. I liked George Michael, whatever, whatever. And I always knew that everybody was always like, oh my God, they love George Michael and they think he looks so good, blah, 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 blah. And I was always like, yeah, okay, whatever. And it was never really solidified in my brain how quote unquote good looking that George Michael was until I seen this video, because then I was like, and that is when I was like, Ermigerd. So that's why. Oh, besides that though, it's really, really good song. The video is good, the song is good, and the musical quality is like 10 out of 10. Like, but that is why Monkey by George Michael is number four. Number three is Everything She Does by The Police, because one day I was in the store and I heard this song and I was like, this is a really good song. And then I heard the beginning and all that and I'm like, this is a really, really good song. And that's really why it's in there, because it's a really good song. So that's why it's in there. Number two is Human Nature by Michael Jackson, because this is a really good song too. And I think most people would acknowledge this as a really, really good song, because 10 out of 10 quality song, nothing more you could say about it. It's just a really nice song and it's from the 80s and it's just one of the best songs ever made, let alone not in the 80s, but just like of all time, which is why it's in there, because it's really, really good. She likes the way I stare. If they say why, tell them that it's human nature. Why, do they do it that way?
So insane, when the other man has none.
Now here's where something becomes a little bit different, because though I did the runner-ups, I usually get to number one first, but this time I have an honorable mention, and here's the reason it's an honorable mention, is because it came out in 1979, so it just barely scraped being the 1980s, so my honorable mention is Angel Eyes by Roxy Music. Number one is Blue Highway by Billy Idol, because this is probably my favorite Billy Idol song, because it's just so good, and there's just so much to love about this song, and I can imagine everything in this song. And though I know that I have the lyrics wrong, I prefer my own lyrics to the actual lyrics of the song, because I just think my lyrics are better. Like, the lyrics I thought were the lyrics, I think are better than the actual lyrics. So, anyways, besides that, it's a really, really good song. It's 10 out of 10. Of course, everybody loves Billy Idol because Billy Idol is really, really good. And everybody should listen to Billy Idol, so that's all. Why do I miss you? That is my list of the best songs from the 80s, part 2. So I thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.